Thank you. And is share the presentation. I will speak from another point of view from the green industry. Now, useful tools in the monitoring in environment are the biosensors and particularly biosensors that monitor the pesticide in the soil. For instance, I came from the microelectronic direction and I moved toward this biosensor field in the last years. We prepared a nanostructured material used for the fabrication of a biosensor for pesticide detection. Greeting from Romania and from my college, and many thanks for invitation to the third edition of the Green Chemistry and Renewable Energy Conference. Few pictures from Romania, where are you always welcome. Here are some castle, including top of the picture, the Dracula castle that is famous. Also, I live in Romania in Bucharest. Here is Bucharest, welcome in Bucharest. And in Bucharest, I work at Politehnica University from Bucharest. Here you have the website of our university to see more details about this. I will pass over this presentation because Sir Chairman very good introduced me. So I, as a conclusion, I am graduated in microelectronics field. And I applied this microelectronics with my group to develop some nanostructured and nanoporous materials used for the immobilization of some receptors. The particularity of this technology is that we not deposit these nanomaterials, we grow direct on the silicon wafer, so that we hope to have better anchoring of the nanomaterial on the principle of absorption. The advantages could be the nanoporous materials for biosensor. They offer intermediate properties between solid state like silicon substrate and an enzymatic membrane. The nanostructured materials are well anchored onto the substrate. The nanopore diameter can be modified depending on the parameters of the technological process of anodizing reaction, so that to adapt our technology to a better immobilization of enzyme and is suitable for miniaturization of biosensors. As a general trend, we need to go toward the miniaturization of biosensors to use as low as possible the quantity of sample and to integrate, for instance, in electronic devices, this directive for the next 10 years to co-integrate the transistors, the electronic devices with the other materials, particularly the biomaterials, to obtain biodevices, like in the similar manner that you, the general principle is present on this picture. On the bottom part, you observe MOS transistor that can easily adapt it to become a biosensors if we adapt and immobilize a receptor in the gate space. And on the top, we apply a drop of electrolyte with analyte. For instance, we have produced successfully a glucose biosensor using also a MOSFET transistor. Some structure is like this of the product published in Biosensors few years ago, and the calibration curve, glucose concentration and drain current is presented in this picture, having a large linear range, but in the domain of a millimol range. As nanostructured materials, we also applied the oxide of titanium, but nanostructured. how it was prepared, the thin titanium metallic film, for instance, the 90 nanometer thickness is deposited on the, exactly on the gate oxide nitride sandwich by spattering in high vacuum. Then the metal, the film, titanium film is converted by anodization in nanotubes of titanium oxide using an electrochemical combine. Here is the same image on the corner of oxide of titanium converted in nanoporous film at 45 and 50 degrees Celsius in nitrogen environment in inducing glutaraldehyde on the edge region. On this, over this oxide of titanium, we prepared the enzymatic membrane that was composed by glutaraldehyde as a cross-link agent, maybe sometimes plus Nafion. And we combine the mechanical thermal property of Nafion with the mechanical and adherence good properties of glutaraldehyde to obtain a membrane of glucose oxidase like is contains here by same image. Also, it's possible to work, for instance, to go from the simulations to some particular results. For instance, here I want to emphasize another aspect, also published in another journal, that for instance, in electronic devices, there is a very well industrial software for simulations very close to the reality is the simulator from Silvaco. And we usually use Atlas and Athena from Silvaco to simulate microelectronic device. But what have we can do with a layer like glucose oxidase, oxide of titanium, as previously I said? In this software can be defined, and we tried and we successfully simulated these devices with a different and atypical layer of glucose oxidase and oxide of titanium, nanostructured, okay, defining in the a new material with a series of properties like dielectric permittivity and what as other property we know we can define as a new material, and then they can be simulated. Also, we used another material that was oxide of aluminum, also converted in nanopores, and we applied these materials anchored directly on the silicon wafer. We convert it in sapphire and by anodizing oxide film, we converted in nanoporous structure that is indicated in this same figure, where also a glucose oxidase enzyme membrane was immobilized on these cheap materials. How was integrated the transducer in the glucose biosensor? We used, for instance, such a kind of electrodes like in this figure, where the upper mask stands for the counter electrode, the middle represents the reference electrode, and the two bottom electrodes, symmetrical placed, are the work one and work two electrodes. Here are some TEM image of some alternative materials, nanomaterials used in biosensors. We synthesized, here is para-aminobenzoic acid as outer shell over nanoparticle of ferrite. And here is a TEM image, and then is a SEM imaging. You can see in the dark part is a nano core of the nanoparticles around 20 nanometers. And the external shell, usually during the TEM imaging, are destroyed. But as in some part can be still observed. Here we also, I forget to say, this PABA NCS is manifest as a P-type semiconductor, organic semiconductor, and also we synthesize the as external shell for on nanoparticle of ferrite, sulfosalicylic acid that was a green organic material for N-type semiconductor. Now I try to pass to pesticides. They are very frequently used in the nowadays agriculture, but pesticides pollute with a large palette of environment, plants, organisms, soil, and water. So using monitoring tools like biosensor of pesticide can put under the control these substances. For instance, we prepared biosensors for organochlorides. No, here is a little history of pesticides. They start from organochlorides at the DDT. Then we deal with organophosphates, carbamates, and new biopesticides. But they produce water pollution, reduce the nitrogen fixation, and consequently reduce the biodiversity, especially for the threatened species. The pesticides disturb not only the pest, but frequently cause the people health disturbing. And they act by parasymptomimetic mechanism as and the entire control of the parasymptomimetic nervous system can be transferred against the pest. For instance, some pesticides operate with inhibition of acetylcholinesterase enzyme, allowing acetylcholine to be transferred in nerves to produce impulses indefinitely and causing different symptoms as weaknesses and paralysis. They can be operated by disrupting the sodium and potassium balance on the nerve fiber and force to continue transmit the impulse to the nerve. Chemical from the parasympathetic group act on two directions, directly by stimulating the nicotinic or muscarinic receptors, or indirectly by the cholinesterase inhibition. Paroxone is one of the novel generation of this parasymptomimetic substance. He has a particular property that is one of the most potent acetylcholinesterase inhibitor. And in high dilution, it represents a high risk of poisoning for humans and animals. Usually it is sprayed on the fruit and on the trees, and their concentration reach to 0.05 to 0.1% in these vegetables. The chemical are banned to use for many food crops. After raining, the pesticides are accumulated in water and in soil. For this kind of pesticide paroxone, we produce a biosensor in the white room that follow in great lines this fabrication flow. We start from the silicon wafer. We applied an initial oxidation, photogravure, porosification of the deposited titanium layer. Then porous treatment with this range for temperature. Then applying the mask M2 for by photogravure, and then deposition of titanium platinum on the face of the chip, then deposition on a rear chromium aurum gold deposition, photogravure for mask 3, deposition of titanium silver, photogravure for mask 4, chemical cleaning, and enzyme deposition over this stack. The biosensor transducer was based on a capacitor structure. From the design stage, the capacitor has a constant armature and a fixed distance between electrodes, so any variation in capacitance reflects the electrical permittivity of the material between electrodes. Here we dropped a sample of soil, of water, contaminated water. This permittivity is proportional with the quantity of ion accumulated after the enzymatic assisted reaction of the pesticide hydrolysis. And to increase the sensor sensitivity, we used also interdigitated electrodes. And we used also as integrated reference electrode on silver chloride electrode. Here are representation of three electrodes. Here are the meander interdigitated electrode, and in the middle is a reference electrode during the design stage. The porous nanostructure has a closer lattice with silicon. So porous silicon also can stand an intermediate material many times more convenient and more compatible with silicon than other nanoporous as previously we presented. For silicon porous, the pore size can be simply adapted during the anodization of the silicon and changing the electrolyte composition. Due to the increased area offered by silicon porous materials against the silicon monocrystalline, an enhanced miniaturization with capacitive electrodes can be performed. Then the conversion of silicon in silicon porous avoid further metal deposition and decrease the costs. Therefore, the silicon porous is selected as intermediate layer for the acetylcholinesterase enzyme entrapping. Here are more details about some key technological process. For instance, the type of silicon was N-type, orientation of the crystals 100, and the initial resistivity 1.7 ohm centimeter. The thermal oxide is grown and patterned to define an Iceland for the implantation with boron from the on the front side, and to convert a thin layer of silicon in from N to P type, because this P type can be easier converted in silicon porous. To convert this CP type in porous silicon was used a prescription from the chemistry department. Here are the report of the acids, acetic and fluorhydric acids, in different ratio, using, for instance, optimal current density more than 1 microampere per square centimeter, but many values were tested during the final process. And the porosity, takes place in the percent of 55%. After the porosification, some annealing process helped to stabilize the film. For instance, 450 degrees Celsius in hydrogen atmosphere, followed by another higher temperature annealing at 950 degrees Celsius in nitrogen environment are applied. Here, practically, as I said, more current density were tested, and for each current density, the center pore depth are indexed in this table. So many values of current density were tested and result different depth for the pore. For instance, the width for the main pore reach 7 micrometer for a current density about 300 milliampere per square centimeter. Obviously, with increased increasing is accompanied by a decreasing of the thickness of the tube walls, probably due to the quiescence of tiny pores. The current density of 50 offers the optimum capillarity for the enzyme solution attracting absorption in these pores. For the enzyme membrine, the acetylcholinesterase was immobilized in serum albumin from bovine provenance using the glutaraldehyde solution, 2.5% concentration as cross-link agent, and the method allows the enzyme applying directly on the silicon-silicon porous surface. A view of this membrane is presented in the above figure, and also as detail we use a phosphate buffer solution to ensure a constant pH of 7 during the measurement. The reference electrode was prepared by silver on silver chloride and was also prepared in the microelectronics technology, so that means in the solid state finally. So we produce a chlorination reaction in solid state over silver film already deposited. And here is a atomic force microscopy image of this structure at the surface of these structures. The final biosensors produced was in this manner, with the reference electrode in the middle and the counter electrode and work electrode, practically two electrodes of measurements with interdigited meanders. The detection limit and the signal noise ratio was 3, with detection limit was 0.5 micromolar for porauxone and 2 micromolar for nitrophenyl, and the linear responses was 0.5, 10 micromolar for parauxone and 5 to 100 micromolar for nitrophenol. Were tested two kinds of finally, two for comparison. The best are for the lowest are for parauxone. Here are some publishing on these topics about this subject of biosensor of pesticides. In conclusions, porous silicon is a promising material for fabrication of sensors detecting pesticides using enzymes as a receptor element, integrating on the near MOSFET transistor. The factors that control the porosification process are the concentration of the chosen electrolyte, the bath temperature of porosification, anodizing current intensity, post-processing annealing. The optimal immobilization is a cross-link with an agent of cross-linking. In the case of immobilization by simple physical absorption of the enzyme, there is a decrease in the enzyme activity due to the washing of the enzyme weakly bound to the surface of the transducer. This is a story about this biosensor of pesticide. Here I invite you, if are interested, to publish some results, because it is open at Biosensor Journal, a special issue concerning organic thin film transistor based biosensors, and you can send the manuscript till 13 September. Thank you very much for your attention, and I'm waiting for your questions.